बोरा फ्रॉम क्रिएटिव टेक्नोलॉजी एंड आर्किटेक्चर ऐश्वर्य जोशी, चेयरमैन सौरभ जैन सर, RFI प्रोफेसर अजय जैन एंड ऑल द डिग्निटरीज एंड पार्टिसिपेंट्स. वी आर हियर फॉर इंटरनेशनल वेबिनार ऑन 3D प्रिंटिंग टेक्नोलॉजी एंड एडिटिव मैन्युफैक्चरिंग. दिस इज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय रिसर्च फाउंडेशन ऑफ इंडिया एंड वर्ल्ड वर्चुअल कॉन्फ्रेंस फोरम. एंड दिस प्रोग्राम इज स्पॉन्सर्ड बाय वर्ल्ड फेडरेशन ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी इंटरनेशनल रिसर्च गाइड फोरम. The all the dignitaries are waiting for few more dignitaries to join, and the scheduled time is 11 a.m. Because we are behind the schedule, so I would like to introduce the Research Foundation of India. What the Research Foundation of India is doing in the field of research, and how the RFI is helping to the research scholars with the help of the renowned stakeholders, which are guiding the students directly or indirectly. The Research Foundation of India is a statutory body, and almost 18,000 persons are attached directly or indirectly with this forum. The Research Foundation of India is organizing international conference, national conference, symposium, workshop, FDP, and all other related activities to enhance the quality of education. The website is shown over here, researchfoundationofindia.com. So you can see the website and see the other activities which we are performing with the help of all research activities with the help of dignitaries. Recently, in the pandemic of COVID-19, we have conducted almost 100 plus webinars, seminars, and other sessions in India and abroad as well. RFI is working throughout the India, not only India, but in the various parts of world, like Singapore, UK, Germany, and other countries also. It is a NGO type organization for no profit, no loss activities. Today we are here for 3D printing technology, and our respected Prime Minister told us that we should go for Atmanirbhar Bharat. There are lack of jobs, so the 3D printing can give us jobs, as well as you cannot go for job, but you can hire some other persons also and give them jobs. So we learn the various aspects of 3D printing. We will see how the machines works, what is the theory of 3D printing, what are the advantages over the other machines manufacturing processes over here, and few more things along with the live video of the machine. We have got various experts with us, and they will show us the path to go with this 3D printing. Now, I would request Professor Ajay Jain to proceed further in this seminar. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Ashok sir. Thank you so much. Sir, we will start our session after 10 or 15 minutes because we are waiting some participants.
Sure, Professor.
Yes. 10 minutes, please. 10 minutes. वेलकम एवरीवन, वेलकम एवरीवन, थैंक यू यू फॉर ज्वाइनिंग अस फॉर टुडेज वेबिनार. गुड मॉर्निंग एंड वेलकम, गुड मॉर्निंग एंड वेलकम टू द इंटरनेशनल वेबिनार फॉर 3D प्रिंटिंग टेक्नोलॉजी ऑन एडिटिव मैन्युफैक्चरिंग. आई एम प्रोफेसर अजय जैन, प्रेसिडेंट सेंट्रल इंडिया बोर्ड RFI. सो हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम टू टुडेज सेशन. मे आई इन्वाइट today's special guest, Dr. Daksha Gupta ma'am. I introduce Mrs. Daksha Gupta, currently residing in Massachusetts, USA. She is working as a market research analyst. She have working experience in drug safety and pharma convalescence. She have M Pharma postgraduate diploma in preventive and promotive healthcare, and it is a certified BASE SAS programmer. She explore her potential, attitude and knowledge to the health and led truth and hard work escort the way to success. She is working in Boston, USA. She worked at DMB Business and Market Research Private Limited as a researcher. She performed secondary research on pipeline products, parsing and reconstructing available data, entering into database using specific tools, manufacturing and tracking time frames to meet deadlines. So, Daksha Gupta ma'am, welcome. Welcome from RFI team. Ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Hello?
Yes, ma'am. Can you hear me? Yes, ma'am.
All right. So, thank you. Thank you so much for welcoming me and for inviting me to this conference. So, before presenting about 3D printing, I would like to start with Saraswati Vandana, if it's all right with everyone.
Yes, ma'am. Please, please.
Please, ma'am.
Okay. So, I would like to pray to Goddess Saraswati, who is a goddess of knowledge, to bless us all. Ya kunde du tushare hare dhavala, ya shubhra vastra vrata, ya veena vardhanda mandit kara, या श्वेत पद्मासना, या ब्रह्माच्युत शंकर प्रभर्ति भेदेवे, सदा वंदिता सामां पातु सरस्वती भगवती निःशेष जाड्यापः. Thank you. So, to start with the presentation, good morning, everyone. It is my great pleasure and honor to welcome all of you to today's conference on 3D printing technology and additive manufacturing. I also wanted to thank Professor Ajay Jain for the kind introduction, and I would like to begin by giving a short introduction of 3D printing. So what is 3D printing? It is also known as additive manufacturing and has been quoted in the Financial Times and by other sources as potentially being larger than the internet. 3D printing is a process for making a physical object from a three-dimensional digital model, typically by laying down many successive thin layers of a material. So there are several different techniques to 3D print an object. So the first technique is stereolithography, which was the first commercial rapid prototyping technology invented by Chuck Lal. And so basically what it does is it takes a liquid plastic as a source material, and this liquid plastic is transformed into a 3D object layer by layer. There is another technique, digital light processing, which is similar to stereolithography. However, it uses a different light source and makes use of a liquid crystal display panel. And there are certain other technologies which I'm not going to get into right now. So the 3D printing industry is growing at a very fast pace with the potential to impact many markets, including healthcare. And so as Ajay Jain professor mentioned that I am from the medical background, and so I have done my master's in pharmacy. So and also working as a medical in a medical company as a market research analyst. So my focus currently is on the medical applications and the advancements which are made in the healthcare industry. So there are many applications of 3D printing which have been used and which has revolutionized healthcare. So the application of 3D printing in medicine can provide many benefits, including the customization and personalization of medical products, drugs, and equipments. So which include custom-made implants, fixtures, and surgical tools. And these can have a positive impact in terms of time required for the surgery, patient recovery time, and the success of surgery or implant. It wouldn't be one size for all the implants made with the help of 3D printing, but they will be unique and specific for each individual or patient, so which is a great advantage in the medical field. So, and another benefit of 3D printing is that it is cost effective, as it can reduce manufacturing cost by decreasing the use of unnecessary resources. So to give an example, a pharmaceutical tablet weighing 10 milligrams could potentially be custom fabricated on demand as a 1 milligram tablet. Some drugs may also be printed in dosage forms that are easier and more cost effective to deliver to patients. Other benefits of 3D printing includes our increased productivity, the democratization of design and manufacturing, and enhanced collaboration. Including these benefits, there are some barriers as well to 3D printings. Like there is an unrealistic expectation and hype. There are some patent and copyright concerns and some regulatory concerns. However, the advancements like robotic bioprinters and robot-assigned surgery may be an integral to the evolution of this technology. So I believe that the advantages beats the disadvantages. And the researcher continue to improve existing medical applications that use 3D printing technology and to explore new ones. The medical advances that have been made using 3D printing are already significant and exciting. But some of the more revolutionary applications, such as organ printing, will need time to evolve. Having said that, I would like to conclude my presentation and would like to thank all of you for listening to me patiently and inviting me to be a part of this conference. I look forward in expanding my knowledge about 3D printing from today's presentation and from listening from each and every one of you. Have a wonderful day, everyone. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks a lot, ma'am. The information you have provided is important for us. You have explained about this technology in detail, so everyone is beneficial for this information. So thank you so much, ma'am, for your valuable time and information. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Now I invite Dr. Saurabh Jain, Chairman Research Foundation of India. जैसा कि हम लोग हर वेबिनार में हर कार्यक्रम में जानकारी देते हैं कि रिसर्च फाउंडेशन ऑफ इंडिया इज प्योर वर्किंग फॉर रिसर्च प्रमोट रिसर्च वर्क प्रमोट एंड सपोर्ट ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड. उसी उसी के रिगार्डिंग पूरे हम लोगों ने इस पेंडेमिक सिचुएशन के दौरान कई सारी एक्टिविटीज परफॉर्म की हैं, कई सारे वेबिनार हुए हैं, कई सारी वर्चुअल कॉन्फ्रेंसेस हुई है, कई सारी क्लासरूम एक्टिविटी की है। उसी के कंसर्ट में ये हमारा 3D प्रिंटिंग टेक्नोलॉजी के ऊपर एक प्रैक्टिकल एस्पेक्ट से जुड़ा हुआ एक कार्यक्रम हो रहा है। सो वेलकम ऑल पार्टिसिपेंट्स। सो नाउ आई इनवाइट डॉक्टर सौरभ जैन सर, चेयरमैन रिसर्च फाउंडेशन ऑफ इंडिया। सौरभ जैन सर।
थैंक यू प्रोफेसर जैन, प्रेसिडेंट सेंट्रल बोर्ड ऑफ इंडिया आरएफआई। एज वी नो वेरी वेल, इन ड्यूरेशन ऑफ कोविड-19 एवरीवन इज फोकसिंग फॉर ऑनलाइन वेबिनार्स एंड वांट टू बी गेनिंग एक्सपीरियंस रिगार्डिंग डिफरेंट इशूज। So Research Foundation of India is going to be organize a international webinar on 3D printing technology in advanced manufacturing with World Federation of Science and Technology, International Research Guides Association and Virtual Conference Forum RFI. I would like to welcome our honorable chief guest Dr. P.K. Chande sir, Founder Director SDSITS Indore, Guest of Honor Dr. Bilas Barodkar, Professor MA NIT Bhopal, Resource Person Engineer Deepak Boraji, Creator Technology Bhopal, Special Guest Mrs. Daksh Gupta, Boston, USA, Honorable Guest Aishwarya Joshi Ji, Department of Architecture and Planning, MANIT Bhopal. Honorable Vice President, Research Foundation of India, Dr. Ashok Kumar Gupta Ji. All eminent scholars, participants, Core Committee Member RFI, Women's Cell Core Committee Member RFI, and Professor Ajay Jain, President and Central Board of India RFI. This intensive webinar is focusing for 3D technologies with related to, it may be related to any disaster. Right now we are suffering from, as we know very well, COVID-19. So it's also important for 3D printing for particular issues. So thank you very much to make that webinar success. Thank you very much. Over to you, Professor Jain, please.
Thank you so much, Dr. Saurabh Jain sir, Chairman Research Foundation of India. Now I welcome Dr. Ashok Kumar Gupta sir. Welcome sir, you are the foundation of all these things. Aap hain to hum hain. Aur जैसा कि सभी लोग जानते हैं और सभी लोगों को पता है, जिनने भी रिसर्च फाउंडेशन ऑफ इंडिया के कार्यक्रम अटेंड किए हैं, सर बोस्टन में थे, वहां पर भी सर ने डे नाइट को डिफ्रेंशिएट ना करते हुए हर कार्यक्रम को देखा, समझा, हमें समझाया और करने के लिए प्रेरित किया। हर कार्यक्रम में आप अवेलेबल रहे, आपके वैल्यूएबल सजेशन हमारे बहुत काम आए। सो सर अगेन वेलकम एंड थैंक यू सो मच। सर डॉक्टर अशोक कुमार गुप्ता सर, वाइस प्रेसिडेंट रिसर्च फाउंडेशन ऑफ इंडिया एंड साउथ एशिया हेड, डॉक्टर अशोक कुमार गुप्ता सर, प्लीज वेलकम सर।
थैंक यू सर। आई लाइक टू थैंक प्रोफेसर एम एल जैन सर हु जॉइन ऑन माय रिक्वेस्ट। थैंक यू सर, यू आर मोस्ट वेलकम। प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर पी के चांदे सर, डॉक्टर विलास वरुलकर सर, ऐश्वर्य जोशी सर, चेयरमैन सौरभ जैन सर एंड ऑल अदर डिग्निटरीज, इट इज अ मैटर ऑफ ग्रेट प्लेजर दैट वी आर कनेक्टिंग ओवर हियर एन इंटरनेशनल वेबिनार ऑन 3D प्रिंटिंग टेक्नोलॉजी एंड एडिटिव मैन्युफैक्चरिंग। द 3D प्रिंटिंग इज नथिंग बट द टाइप ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग प्रोसेस बाय एडिटिव टेक्नोलॉजी। There is no any limitation of 3D printing. you can manufacture what you can think, and you can design what you can think. After designing, you can proceed further with the help of this latest technology. The 3D printing is not very much costly. As you will see here, that the manufacturer is also available with us, manufacturer, supplier, and the demonstrator. They are also available with us, and they will show the concept of 3D printing with the help of 3D designing directly from computer to manufacturing. There is no any hassle between the thinking and manufacturing. So 3D printing is the art of technique of the day, and we must know, every engineer, every doctor, every pharmacist, every architect, every person who want to make his idea into a reality must learn this technique. So over to Professor Ajay Jain. Thanks for calling me, and thanks all the dignitaries and participants for joining this fruitful session. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for your valuable suggestion. Always available for us and valuable guidance. So again, thank you so much, sir. Keep blessing us. Now I introduce our today's guest, architect Aishwarya Joshi, sir. Aishwarya Joshi, sir, currently running architecture firm as well as 3D printing company. He also worked in sheet metal, involving to design furniture using CNC machine. He is having exposure of programming also. He is granted in architecture firm. He is graduated in architecture from MANIT Bhopal. So welcome, Dr. Architect Aishwarya Joshi, sir. Welcome, sir.
Yeah, hello. Perfectly.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Hello, everyone. I'm architect Aishwarya Joshi. Good morning to you all. So I'm here to tell you about 3D printing. So 3D printing is a wide term nowadays, but there are many technologies involving 3D printing. So, like, for the use of every technology, you need certain specific. Without the proper technology and proper application, you cannot do anything. So basically, 3D printing is, I have a 3D printer over here to show you all. So basically, here is a spool of plastic wire. This particular spool is made of PLA. You can have many materials such as polycarbonate, polylactic acid, polypropylene, ABS, depending upon the usage. Such as if you are trying to make a part that is usable for edible purposes or storing edible items. So you will want to go for ABS, because usually these kind of items are made of ABS. So on, you can choose the material based upon your requirement. If you are going for some industrial application, you can print in nylon as well. So this spool is fed into a motor over here. You can see this thing rotating over here. This motor is pushing down the filament from this pipe and pushing through this heater block located behind the fans you are seeing. Then the filament is pushed through the heater block, and you can see a small nozzle down over here. So the filament is laid down on the bed, and basically what the computer does is slices your 3D model into hundreds of layers. In this case, this is a 2-hour long print over here, and this is having some 700 something layers. So there are various technologies involving 3D printing. So I'll give you a brief description about why you should choose a particular technology. Okay, so first is FDM. FDM printer is a printer you are seeing right over here. So FDM printer is why you should choose an FDM printer is because it is a very cheap printer. You can get it for like 20 to 25,000 nowadays. So it is very cheap, but it has its drawbacks because they have no service providers. You will have to do most of your work by yourself. So parts produced are strength wise, if you say, parts are good, but it totally depends upon your material in which you are printing. So what is the limitation? So it requires support material for printing. So if you are printing overhangs, like say if you are printing this object like in such orientation, so this is a overhang. So this will, you cannot have more overhangs than 45 to 50 degrees roughly. So after that we'll come to SLA. So SLA printing is used for manufacturing small high precision parts. So as I mentioned, this FDM printer has a resolution of 10 microns. So any detail smaller than that will be will not be printed simply. So if you want more detail, you should go for SLA printing. SLA is stereolithography. Stereolithography, in stereolithography we use resin. A liquid resin is used, which is cured by some kind of UV light source. So SLA printing has multiple types. SLA printing has DLP, LCD and laser. So what DLP does is has a sort of mesh which floats on the resin, and as the laser passes on the resin, the resin solidifies on the plate, and the plate is lowered by the machine itself, and the plate is lowered in the numbers of microns. Like you can have the precision of 1 micron as well. So it will be lowered, and the laser will again cure the laser and the print, and then again the print will be lowered, and then again the laser will pass, and such that the object is built. So it is very precise, but you cannot go for large parts because the machines that are available nowadays doesn't allow that. So it has some more problems, like the part after printing is not ready for use as it's printed. It will be need to cured into the sunlight or into a UV lamp to cure the resin perfectly. After that, second drawback is the process of cleaning the resin from the part is very messy because the part is completely submerged into the resin when the printing process is going on. So you need to take the part out and then wash it up with some chemicals and etc. So after that, it is SLS. SLS is selective laser sintering. This is relatively very new technology, and it will have a lot of potential in future years because right now it is very expensive, but soon it will be available to, I think, the local market because the costs are coming down very quickly. So this type of technology works by fusing powdered material. You see here we are using a plastic wire which is melted and placed into the object we are seeing over here. So in SLS printing we use a powder based building material which is placed into a box, and then layer by layer the object is built by fusing the layers of nylon powder over one another. So process has a lot of benefits as well as a lot of disadvantages. So the advantages of this process are the parts produced are very strong. So you can use them in various objects directly without going for injection molding or anything. Hello? Can you hear me?
Yeah, we are here.
Yes, sir.
Please continue.
Please mute all. जिनने भी ओपन किया है प्लीज माइक म्यूट करा सर प्लीज सर प्लीज कंटिन्यू करिए आप
सो बेसिकली व्हाट हैपेंस इज इन दिस काइंड ऑफ एसएलएस प्रिंटिंग द लेयर्स ऑफ नायलॉन्स आर लेड ओवर वन अनदर एंड लेयर बाय लेयर द नायलॉन इज यूज्ड टू मेक अ ऑब्जेक्ट सो इट इज वेरी हाई स्ट्रेंथ पार्ट एंड इट कैन बी यूज्ड इन हाई स्ट्रेंथ एप्लीकेशंस डायरेक्टली So the drawback is you have to clean the part after because the part basically arrives in a block of powdered nylon and you have to use an air gun to blow all the nylon off the part and you get a part in that powdered nylon. The advantage of that powdered nylon in between is that you don't need any support material. So support material if I say to you support materials, if I am printing a hollow object, then removing the support material can be a big challenge. So powdered nylon can be blown with air very easily. So you don't need any support. That is why you can print working components. Like say I have a model of this plier on my AutoCAD or whatever 3D software I am using, 3ds Max, SketchUp, whatever. So when I am going to slice this thing, it will say I cannot print this plier as a whole in this printer because it has moving components. And when I will try to print, say, this rivet will be fused with everything else. This plier will no longer be working. Like this. But if I am printing in SLS, I can print a working set of plier directly. So with that, I would like to conclude my talk. If you have any questions about 3D printing, you can ask me.
Thank you so much, Aishwari Yasir sir. Thank you so much to give important information on 3D printing technology and its practical aspects. With these efforts, this technology will soon reach all the peoples. Again, thank you so much, sir, for your valuable information about 3D printing technology. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, everyone, for listening to me. Here you can see an object in the building. If you pay attention to it, it's slowly rising.
Okay, sir.
Joshi, can you show your this video in a broader ways on front page? We are watching. Can you please focus your camera to the machine, please?
Sure.
Sir, it is surface printing, right, sir?
Very nice. Yes.
Okay.
Good. Thank you.
Okay, sir.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.
Okay, sir.
Thank you.
I'll let this play.
Yes, sir.
You please carry on with the next.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. So all participants and all guests, again, welcome from RFI team. So I introduce today's guest of honor, Dr. Viraj Varudkar, sir. Dr. Viraj Varudkar obtained his BA Mechanical Engineering from MSCT Bhopal, MTech and PhD degree from MANIT Bhopal. Presently, he is Associate Professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering at Maulana Azad National Institute of Technology, Bhopal. He has over 17 years of teaching experience at undergraduate and postgraduate level. His broad areas of interest including machine design and renewable energy. He has published over 42 research papers in various international and national journals and conferences. He has attended 12 international and 10 national conferences. He has been member of 7 professional bodies such as SAE, ASME, ISTD, and PhD Chamber of Commerce and Industry, ACSI, GWEA. He has visited many countries such as Germany, Malaysia, Japan, China, UK, Spain, and Denmark for presenting research paper in international conference. So welcome Dr. Vikas Vadvudkar, sir. Welcome, sir. Please guide and address us. Welcome, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Welcome.
Thank you, Dr. Jain. So I hope I am audible.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So firstly, I think I have to speak later. So I think I was expecting Chandra sir to speak first. Anyhow, so I would like to. I think my camera is being blocked by my antivirus. So I hope this will do. So as already Professor Gupta and Aishwarya has already mentioned that the additive manufacturing or 3D printing is an manufacturing technology. It is not at all an emerging one because it has developed a lot in few decades. And this technology allows for the direct transformation of digital data into a physical product. At first sight, the additive manufacturing process chain may look very short and simple. And the computer design softwares are being used for describing a physical object. And the digital data is being then transferred to a special 3D printer, which directly produces the part. And but what sounds very simple has many challenges as well. And there are various printing technologies being available. What they have in common is that they all build 3D objects by adding material. It is either layer wise or by deposition along a path. The diverse printing processes are based on different materials. For example, sand, solid or liquid plastics. Then also some numerous metals are being associated as materials, and also different methods for building the layers. As Ashwar has already told that the different methods. So like to brief some like laser or electron beam for melting then and fusing sintering of the metal powder. As the 3D printing technology has been advanced, the 3D printed parts have moved decidedly outside the research and development arena, and it's now onto the production line. And these pivotal processes are developing and producing the concepts previously unattainable in the manufacturing world. And entrepreneurs to the Fortune 500 companies and large OEMs have embraced the advanced enterprise of 3D printing to meet their tough performance standards and requirements as well. As companies have designed for the additive manufacturing or 3D printing and utilize it as a complement to the traditional manufacturing, new applications have come to the scene, and it has changed what has been possible. And also, I would like to brief some applications part in the various industries. So first industry, which is important one, is the aerospace industry. So the aerospace companies were some of the first to adopt the 3D printing, and some of the toughest industry performance standards exist in this particular industry, and which requires parts to hold up in very harsh conditions. So engineers are designing and manufacturing for the commercial and the military aerospace platforms, which need the flight worthy components made from the very high performance materials as well. And also 3D printing delivers very complex consolidated parts with high strength, and less material, and the consolidated design result in overall weight reduction, which is the one of the most important factors in the manufacturing for aerospace. And the benefits of 3D printing for major companies and the organization continues to push forward the innovative designs and the applications for the flight world. Then the next application particular is a medical one, and one of the most important one. The rapidly innovating medical industry is utilizing the 3D printing solutions to deliver the breakthroughs to doctors, patients, and research institutions as well. And the medical manufacturers are utilizing the wide range of high strength and biocompatible 3D materials, from rigid to the flexible and opaque to transparent, and to customize the designs which have never have been assumed. And from functional prototypes and true to life anatomical models to the surgical grade components, the additive manufacturing is opening the door to unforeseen advancements for the life saving devices as well. Some applications which are shaking up the medical industry are the orthopedic implant devices, dental devices, pre-surgery models from CT scans, custom saw and drill guides, and the specialized instrumentation particular. Also the Stratasys direct manufacturing continues to expand its offerings to support the medical applications, such as seamless medical carts, anatomical models, and the custom surgical tools as well. The material development is also a key in this industry, as the more validation of biocompatible materials and the methods used to produce parts could open the door for the more customized implants, the life-saving devices, and pre-surgical tools that increase the patient's outcomes. Then the next is the transportation, and in this the life is in the fast lane means the endurance to the very tough environments like extreme speeds and heat. The transportation industry needs parts that stand up to the harsh testing and are lightweight enough to avoid the unnecessary drag. And with a wide array of rugged high temperature materials and the 3D printing technologies and the ability to build very complex geometries, the transportation companies are just scratching the surface of what can be made additively manufactured for their particular vehicles. And some of the applications that have transformed the industry include the the complex duct work that can't be fabricated with the conventional manufacturing methods, resilient prototypes, elastomeric models, grills, custom interior features, and large paneling. The continuing advancements in the 3D printing have also opened up new opportunities for the end use and the mass customization applications. And one of the most exciting applications realized today is the opportunity to reproduce aftermarket parts for restoring the classic cars, which you called generally the re-engineering. Then another industry which is using the 3D printing technology is the energy industry. So the success in the energy sectors hinges on the ability to quickly develop the tailored mission critical components that can withstand the extreme conditions. So 3D printing's advancements in producing efficient on-demand lightweight components and environmentally friendly materials provides the answers for its diverse requirements and page function. Some key applications that have emerged from the gas, oil, and the energy industries include rotors, stators, turbine nozzles, downhole tool components and models. Also, the fluid water flow analysis, flow meter parts, mud motor models, pressure gauge pieces, control valve components, and pump manifolds. And with the development of the corrosion resistant metal materials for customized parts that may need to experience the underwater or other harsh environments, there is no telling that what major energy companies may accomplish with the 3D printing technology. Another important the user is the consumer products. For designers, the graphic artists, and also for the marketing teams, the time it takes to form an idea and deliver it to the market is everything. It is a very important part. And part of that time is simulating the look and the feel of the final product during the design reviews to prove the ideas to the key stakeholders is an important thing. So consumer product manufacturers have embraced the 3D printing to help develop iterations and quickly adjust design. And 3D printing is great for producing the detailed consumer electronics early in the product development life cycle with the realistic aesthetics and functionality. Also, sporting goods have benefited from the early iterations delivered quickly and with very fine details. Another successful application include the entertainment props and costumes as well. Lightweight models, sets, and finely detailed architectural models. I think Aishwarya must be using these models as well in his architectural practice. So as 3D printing technology advances in the speed and build volume, more consumer products may turn to the additive manufacturing for their large volume demands. So that's all from my side, Jain sir. So Chandra sir, namaskar. Main Vilas hu aur 2003 mein maine manage join kiya to uske baad aap as a director aaye the to kafi interaction raha tha us samay. I think uske baad se kafi interaction chhut gaya. So ek baar phir se namaskar sir aapko.
Namaskar. Am I audible?
Yeah, you are audible, sir.
Okay, good.
Yes, sir. Welcome, Chandya sir, and thank you so much, Vilas sir. Thank you very much, sir, for giving important information to all of us. The information given by you will help in understanding this technology. This technology is very important in today's time. It has completely changed the real world. It will also be important in the development of humanity in all over the world. So again, thank you so much, Vilas sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
So now introduce and welcome today's function chief guest, Dr. P.K. Chande sir. Dr. P.K. Chande sir, ex-director MNIT Bhopal, former director at SGSITS Indore, former visiting professor at Kumamoto University, Japan, IIM Indore professor emeritus, former professor at IIM Indore, director NMINS Indore, executive member RGTU, governor's nominee, Margadarshak at AICTE. So welcome, Dr. P.K. Chande sir. Welcome, sir. Please guide and address us. Welcome, sir. Welcome.
Okay. Can I project my PPT? My time
yes,
is
sir,
very
please.
Short. My time is short, so I'll try to, accommodate whatever I want to say. I'm not expert in this field. Hello?
Yes, sir. Please, sir.
Audible?
Yes, sir.
Is my screen visible?
Yes, sir. Chande sir,
yes, sir.
On.
Mera screen dikh raha hai aapko?
Bilkul, first class dikh raha hai, sir.
Okay. Okay, so first of all, let me thank Professor Ashok Gupta, Professor Jain, and then lastly, I was listening to Professor Vikas Marutkar, and the topic was not directly of interest to me, but now it has become very much interesting. Now, generally, Chief Guest speaks at the beginning of the programs. But I don't know, I had put into the second level so that I get some knowledge from Professor Vikas, and then I am able to speak something. So, congratulations to the Research Foundation of India. And I can see that professors of MNIT are taking a lead role in really taking this Research Foundation of India forward. So, what I want to say today, I'll try to look down the memory lane, and the topic which have been listed in the program is 3D global impact, improved technique, role of 3D technology, and 3D additive technologies. And I am supposed to speak a little bit on improved techniques. So I'll try to do my best to do the justice to the topic. And again, Mr. Vikas has listed more than sufficient area where 3D printing can be used. Automobile, he covered automobile, healthcare, aerospace, and biotechnology. Apart from that, he added areas like transport and making of turbine nozzles. The most important thing which he mentioned, in my opinion, in the energy sector is that on-demand components. Because 3D printing is, we know it for prototyping. What he said over here is on-demand component development. So I feel that this is a very important area where 3D printing can find a great scope for making the plants functional at a faster rate. Then he also spoke about consumer product design. Now you can see here that these days, consumer products have very short lifespan, life cycle. So you need to keep on inventing continuously on consumer products. So I feel that is another area where 3D printing would be of very much useful. Other thing, before going further, I want to mention that in India and in my profession, we have been very good in organizing the seminars. It's good that this opens the eyesight, the vision of youngsters, and then they get to know what is going on in the latest area like 3D printing. But my opinion and suggestion is that when we are trying to talk about local, the vocal for local and made in India, I think we should also look into this area whereby we should be able to become self-sufficient in making 3D printing viable in the country, or rather exporting, try to export our machines if we can make in this particular area. Now we have seen, I was looking back till 1990, where I used to work in the area of robotics and AI. We found that when an era of computer science has come up, the flexible manufacturing system and computer integrated manufacturing systems had come up. And they have changed the entire manufacturing system and production systems. So there we could not catch up. And Japan was the first to catch it up and then produce mass production of automobiles and other items also. So I felt that in late 1990s, we have missed the era of FMS, CIM, and to larger extent, AI also, artificial intelligence. Now AI is also playing a big role when we start talking about Industry 4.0. Then the era of CAD came in. Now CAD has simplified the design aspect of all mechanical systems which are with an employed CIM. So CAD is also very important. CIM is also very important. And when we combine these two technologies and these two aspects, then the quality of the product can be achieved. So I still remember that in early 2000, we started talking about quality. And at various forums, we started discussing what do you mean by quality. And still we keep on discussing quality in various forums, including education also. And we are unable to decide how a quality can be achieved. So quality is something which cannot be achieved at the far end of manufacturing. But quality is something which is a part and parcel of each and every step of manufacturing or education or anything. So we have learned now, I hope we have learned about handling the quality. So far as the manufacturing is concerned, that's why we have become globally competitive so far as the manufacturing is concerned. Then Japanese have given another concept like JIT, just in time, so that you can reduce your inventory and so on. So all these aspects are gradually developing in last 20 years or 15 years. And now we have come to a level where we have started talking about Industry 4.0. Now, another thing which I want to emphasize over here is that without materials and material management, we have learned how to handle material. So material management is possible because today we can get any material from Japan or Korea, so far as the steel is concerned. But how to produce materials which are useful for 3D printing is still a challenge for India. So I believe and I feel that we should give more emphasis on development of materials in India, because without material, without composite materials and things like that, we'll not be able to go ahead and prove our leadership in 3D printing. So materials, in my opinion, is very important, and the Research Foundation, I suggest that we should do more emphasis and give seminars on materials and material management and kind of materials required and the kind of technology which is going into 3D printing design machines. It may be a small object or artifact, or it may be a building, or it may be a wing of an airplane. So dimensionally, you can see that 3D printing is encompassing all areas. It is also encompassing biomaterials. So the area is very big, and we should jointly do efforts like computer science, then instrumentation engineers, mechanical engineers, controlling systems engineers. We should do all joint efforts to really develop this area where we can have indigenous 3D printing. Now, 3D printing is going to evolve day by day. It may have multiple facets. For example, when you are printing a object, then can we check up the quality of printing online? I do not know right now that there is any feedback system involved, because I have done 3D printing myself. I'll show you one of the objects which we printed, and then we face a lot of difficulties over there. Innovations, we all are talking up, and 3D printing is certainly helping us to really test and try new innovations in any area. And this is becoming possible because of the fast prototyping, which is becoming available at the institute level. I do not know about industries, but certainly all leading institutions these days have a 3D printing setup. And some of them are not working, as it is said, that some of them need a lot of support for maintenance and things like that. So we have to also work on how to choose a 3D printing infrastructure, from where we should import it, or whether we should manufacture it, or how to make it more accurate, and how to see that while we are printing, will we be able to control the quality? There are different methods for quality control in 3D printing, but can we go ahead in that direction? It will be very, very important, because once the product is printed, you cannot redo it, so it will go to waste. So this is one of the thoughts which came to my mind. This is a product prototype which I had developed. We'll go from right to left. It is a device which we developed, and I have applied for patent for this device. Now in this device, it is a telescopic arrangement to lower a ceiling fan. At the left hand side, you can see that it comes to around 4 to 5 feet height. Now at that height, you can really clean the fan very well and then push it up. In the middle, you can see that the fan is being pushed up. Now important things are two. Number one is the fail-safe lock, because the ceiling fan in no time can be expected to fall down, because it may cause off injuries. So that is the first thing which we have developed. And it is a kind of fail-safe lock, triple fail-safe lock, which we developed using 3D printing, which cannot be shown over here. But second thing is the pipes which you see, telescopic pipes, which we have printed at the facilities available at GSITS. Now, before doing that, I visited many industries and tried to work out my system using concentric pipes, and those pipes are not available in the market. So ultimately we thought of designing it on 3D printing, and you can see that the model is before you. So if 3D printing is available, I'm sure more and more youngsters and engineers will be able to realize their ideas, and then later on they can find out what are shortcomings in these ideas and designs, and then can go for manufacturing at a faster rate, so that quality will be good and the manufacturing process will be faster, and choosing material in the right time will also add up to the overall quality delivery and reduction in the cost. So in general, my comment would be 3D printing is the technology of the time, of the day, and India should look forward to take it up. So thank you very much. This is what I wanted to add up as the chief guest of the program for additive manufacturing. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. आपके कई सारे सजेशन इस टेक्नोलॉजी के बारे में है, इससे रिलेटेड एप्लीकेशन, इससे रिलेटेड एस्पेक्ट। रिसर्च फाउंडेशन ऑफ इंडिया इनोवेटिव टेक्नोलॉजी, करंट टेक्नोलॉजी के ऊपर हमेशा से काम करता आया है, और आपके सजेशन के आधार पे हम लोग जरूर सर प्रयास करेंगे आपसे पूरा गाइडेंस लेके। सो थैंक यू वेरी मच सर, मे वी ऑलवेज गेट योर गाइडेंस एंड सपोर्ट। थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर एड्रेसिंग अस, फॉर योर एक्सपीरियंस एंड नॉलेज हैज ऑलवेज बीन अ गाइड फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस। योर टेक्निकल नॉलेज ऑलवेज टीचेस अस अ लॉट। Thank you so much, sir, for that you give such a significant and valuable time for this webinar on 3D printing technology. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Yeah. So now time for today's session expert, Dr. Deepak Bora, sir. Dr. Deepak Bora, sir, के साथ हम लोग काफी सारी चीजें इस विषय के ऊपर पहले भी कर चुके हैं और हमारी काफी सारी वर्कशॉप भी हो चुकी है। तो दीपक बोरा सर को इस टेक्नोलॉजी को सभी दूर पहुंचाने का श्रेय तो जाता ही जाता है, और साथ ही साथ थैंक यू सो मच सर फॉर इंट्रोड्यूस दिस टाइप्स ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी फॉर एवरीवन। सो आई इंट्रोड्यूस डॉक्टर दीपक बोरा इज फ्रॉम क्रिएटिव टेक्नोलॉजी भोपाल टू क्रिएट अवेयरनेस अमंग फैकल्टी एंड स्टूडेंट फॉर 3D प्रिंटिंग। प्रेजेंटेशन इज फॉलो बाई अ लाइव डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन ऑफ 3D प्रिंटिंग। As per Dr. Deepak Bora, 3D printing is latest technology for rapid prototyping. It is a very cost-effective solution for converting 3D design into physical modules. It can also be used for design optimization and design verification. So, sir, welcome Dr. Deepak Bora, sir. Please take your session, Dr. Deepak Bora, sir. Welcome, sir.
Thank you, Jain sir. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes. Yes, okay. Sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you, Jain Sahab. And it's a pleasure to be sharing the same screen with Dr. Chande and Dr. Varudkar, because I also happen to be from Manit. And I would love to know, always associate with people who are from Manit. Without wasting more time, I will get straight away into the presentation. Lot of you have already heard Dr. Varudkar and Dr. Chande about what is 3D printing. I will only try and gather everything into a presentation and give it to you. So the topic today is additive manufacturing using 3D printing. Additive manufacturing is a process of addition as opposed to subtractive manufacturing, which is the normal way of producing things. In subtractive manufacturing, we start with a large block of steel or plastic, and using various machining processes, reduce it to the item we want. In additive manufacturing, we are doing addition of layer by layer and producing the item. Therefore, it is called additive manufacturing. And secondly, 3D, what is 3D printer and why do we call it a 3D printer? We are using this printer to produce an object in three dimension, that is length, breadth, and height, as opposed to your normal computer printers where things are printed on a paper along the length and the width. We are also giving it height or depth. Therefore, it is called 3D printing. As Dr. Chande rightly mentioned, we are in the fourth stage of industrial revolution. In the first stage, we started off by using steam, which James Watt gave us, to mechanize the production process. In the second stage, Ford gave us mass production using an assembly line belt. In the third stage, we started using electronics and IT to program the machines and to use AI or computer systems to do repetitive jobs. Now we are in the fourth stage, which is called the cyber physical system. Why do we call it cyber physical system? We call it cyber physical because you can transmit your commands over the web in cyberspace. this gives us an advantage that the designer or the person who wants to produce something does not necessarily have to be near a printer. You can give the commands over the web through cyberspace, and your commands would be executed at some other point where the 3D printer is installed. So physically, one does not have to be there. This is of great advantage, because a designer or a person who knows how to produce something does not necessarily have to be physically present at all the places where these things are being produced. Secondly, because of this advantage, you can produce the same item in 10 different locations through one designer only. Is there a question?
Is there a question from TIDI?
Hello? हेलो
हाँ बराबर
काम तो चल रहे हैं यार मेरा तो ये कहना था कि अपन काम से बहुत करते हैं आई एम हियरिंग समबडीज वॉइस कैन समबडी
हेलो क्या करते हैं कि अपन कोई और कोटेशन
डॉक्टर चांदे योर माइक इज ओपन वुड यू प्लीज टर्न इट ऑफ Sorry for that.
Sir, please continue.
Sorry for that, Dr. Chande, but it was causing a little disturbance.
Sir, muted. Please continue.
Okay. Now, what is 3D printing? Basically, 3D printing is a four-step process. The first process is modeling. That is to make a 3D model using a 3D software like CAD or SolidWorks, whereby you can design a product in three dimensions. But once the product is designed, a printer cannot print it as it is. It needs to be divided into very thin slices, just like cutting into thin slices. This again is done using a software, which is called the slicing software. Both for modeling and slicing, various softwares are available on the web, which are free to use. Advanced softwares, of course, are patented softwares, and one has to pay either a subscription for them or you can buy a license to use them. But to begin with, you can use freely available software on the web. For modeling, you can use SketchUp or Tinkercad. For slicing, you can use Cura. After the product is sliced, it has to be printed. So in the slicing software, we generate a G code, which is a printing code, and save it on an SD card, which is then inserted into the printer. As we go along, I'll explain these things. Once the information is fed to the printer, it is a hands-free operation. The printer will work according to the instructions on this SD card, and printing will start. Once the item is printed, it needs post-finishing like painting, making it smoother, or other operations which may be called for. So you see on the screen, the method in the bottom is shown. There is a 3D CAD model which generates a file with an extension of STL. STL is in a short form for stereolithography, because Stratasys, which made the first printer, named it as stereolithography. And stereolithography means adding layer by layer. Once the STL file is generated, it is sent to a software, which is the slicing software, which slices it into thin layers and gives the tool path. Then it is fed to the 3D printer, and the 3D object is printed. Now, if you get into the history of 3D printing, I would not call it something that is a very new technology. It actually started way back in 1984 when Chuck Hull invented the first 3D printer, the stereolithographic printer, also called the SLA printer. It was patented by Stratasys in 1990, and because they had the patent, for 20 years nobody could do anything about it, and only Stratasys has had a monopoly over it. They called it the fused deposition modeling, or FDM. Later on, RipRap came out with a new printer, and they called it fused fabrication, fused filament fabrication, FFF. Basically, the two technologies are the same, where a material is fed into a heater, it is melted, and dropped drop by drop, according to the information given on the SD card, to generate a product which is designed on the CAD. After the patent was completed in 2010, lot of other companies started making printers, and it became a worldwide phenomenon. Now, there are various types of 3D printing, as Mr. Joshi gave you a brief idea. There are basically three types of printings. One is extrusion, second is light polymerization, and the third is powder bed. In extrusion, the most common system used is FDM, which is fused deposition modeling. In light polymerization, we have SLA, DLP, and in powder bed, we have SLS. 90% of the 3D printing today is done using FDM. Therefore, I will talk more of FDM. It is commonly available. Printers are quite inexpensive, whereas SLA, DLP, SLS are quite expensive printers even today, and it is not commonly available. The printer that Mr. Joshi showed you, it was the Cartesian printer. There are two types of printers in FDM. One is a Cartesian printer and one is a Delta printer. In Cartesian printer, it is the head which moves on two axes, and the bed is mounted on a lead screw. Through the lead screw, the bed moves down from top to bottom, and the head moves from left to right and along the Y coordinate also. In Delta printers, the bed is fixed. It is at the lower end, and it is the head which moves up along the Z axis. Again, command to both the heads is given through the SD card. So basically, it is the same process, only the mechanical part is different. But the advantage of Delta printers is it is a light weight head that is moving. So it is able to give you better accuracy, a finer layer thickness. The materials. Today, there is a whole range of materials that can be used in 3D printing. Within FDM also, the primary materials are PLA, which is polylactic acid, ABS, which is acrobutyl styridine, HIPS, which is a high performance plastic, nylon you all know, and also PVA, which is another form of plastic derived from petrochemicals. Besides that, we have advanced materials like T-glass, which has glass fiber reinforcement, flexible material, polycarbonate, carbon fiber inserted material, CPLA, HCPLA, and ULTEM. All these are high performance materials. Again, in 3D printing, 70% of the total FDM printing is done using PLA. Another 10 to 15% is done using CPLA and HCPLA, which are high performance PLA. The reason that PLA is used is because it is easily manufactured. Secondly, the biggest advantage of PLA is it is a biodegradable material. PLA stands for polylactic acid, and polylactic acid is made using starch. Most of PLA is made using corn starch, and as Dr. Chande pointed out, that materials is the area that we should think of when we think of 3D printing. So for everybody's information, PLI has already been manufactured in India. There are two companies which have started production of PLI, and we are already self-sufficient in PLI. Of course, for high-tech and advanced materials, we still depend on companies which are not based in India. But a lot of research is going on, and hopefully we should be able to develop these materials also very soon. Now, just to give you a brief idea of the other types of printing also, SLA, as I told you, is stereolithography. In this, ultraviolet light is used to cure photopolymer resins. Photopolymer resins are resins which are affected by application of light. This, as you can see, is a laser source. The laser beam is focused onto the resin, and wherever the beam strikes the material, that material hardens according to the G-code given on the SD card, and the product is formed. Slowly, the tank is lowered, so the project rises up, whereas the tank is going down. It can also be done in the reverse fashion, that the bed on which the product is being formed is raised and the product comes down. As you see in the photograph on the screen, the product at the bottom is the product that is being formed. Hello. The third system is the SLS printing. Again, a laser is used here for fusion of material. The raw material in this case is powdered material, which is put on a bed. You can see there is a powder delivery system. There is a pusher, a roller, which pushes it onto a bed, which is the powder bed. There is a scanner system which focuses the laser onto the powder according to the instructions given to it. And slowly the bed is lowered and the product is formed. One question that is often asked is that what happens to the powder that is surrounding the product and is not fused? Well, that product powder is sucked using a vacuum system, and after filtration, it can be reused. So there is no wastage of the powder. This is a short screenshot of a McKinsey report. McKinsey is one of the leading consultancy company in the world, and they have done a study on the disruptive technologies that will change our world. As you can see, the first is mobile internet, which is already in use. Renewable energy is happening in a big way. And then the third is additive manufacturing, which we are talking of today. 3D printing is a part of additive manufacturing. There are other systems also. And since it is a disruptive technology that is going to change our world, it is most important that we try and understand what is going on. The fourth is robotics. Dr. Chanda has already talked about it. Then we have autonomous vehicles, which you all know, Google is in a big way talking about it. Then genomics, where genetic engineering is being used. Then IoT, advanced materials, cloud computing, and energy storage, which you are all aware of. The reason for showing this chart was to give you an idea of how important it is to understand 3D printing. Now, why do we need 3D printing? That is a very important aspect. We have talked about this technology for a while now, but why should we use it? The biggest advantage of 3D printing is that you can do a product customization. Product customization means that you can build a product according to your need and according to your requirement. And you can build only one-off product. You don't have to mass produce it. mass production always requires a lot of die making or tooling or machining, and normally the producer will say that I need a minimum order quantity. The advantage of 3D printing is you don't need to have anything like a minimum order quantity or to make a lot of dies or tools. You can just make a design using a 3D software like CAD, print it, and if required, you can make changes in it, small changes, which would otherwise have required a lot of tooling to be redone or dies to be remade, can be done simply by erasing some lines or changing certain dimensions. So basically, it is a great thing for making prototypes to begin with and to do a validation of your design. The second advantage of 3D printing is you can use multiple materials. The printer shown to you was a single nozzle printer. So it was showing you only one color printing. Later on, they added a second color, as you can see. So you can have up to six nozzles with six different materials and give commands so as to print different product using different materials. So those parts of the product which do not have to undergo any stress or do not have to bear any load can be made of material which is inexpensive, and those parts which have to bear stress, load or impact can be made using a different material which can withstand these difficult conditions. The third advantage is that there is a very low human error in 3D printing. Once you have made a CAD file and given the instructions through a slicing software to the printing to the printer, there is no human interface. So chances of human error are almost zero. At the same time, if you observe while printing that there is something that is not right and needs to be modified, you can pause the printer, change the drawing again, and restart the printer or start all over again. So that is a big advantage. The fourth advantage is that you can save a lot of money and time. With 3D printing, as soon as the design is ready, it can be fed to the printer and it can be started. Nowadays, most printers don't need a human interface. So once the printing is started, a human operator does not need to be there. Therefore, it can work 24/7. Secondly, money is saved because the designs do not need to be physically transported anywhere. Like I said earlier, over the cyberspace, you can send the design to the print farm or to the place where your lab is, where the printer is installed, and the printer will automatically start and the printing will start. Applications of 3D printing. The largest application of 3D printing is rapid prototyping. Why do we call it rapid prototyping? Because we can produce the prototype in very short time. Some of the items that you see here are new models of what would be made later on using mass manufacturing and some other technique. The first slide is robotic fingers. The second is an engine model. The third is two parts of a heat gun. And the fourth is hand tools. I will be showing you more samples as we go along. This is a very exciting application because now you can make toys which are custom built for a particular client, and no two toys will look alike. So it will make it unique to the person who wants that toy. You can customize your mobile covers. You can customize speakers. You can customize anything. I think Dr. Vilas spoke about application in medical devices. Surprisingly, even though 3D printers were invented by engineers and first applications were by engineers, the largest user today of 3D printers is the medical fraternity. You see here the various applications of 3D printing for medical devices. The blueprint you see is a cast. Now, normally when somebody fractures a bone, they put a plaster of Paris cast, which has to be put for 40 days. It's a very heavy cast. And after its removal also, the person, the patient feels that it is still there. And that residual memory is always there, that you keep your hand in a particular position or you don't bend your leg. Thirdly, it causes skin irritation many times. So all that can be avoided by using the simple cast that is shown here. It is printed in two parts. It is hollow, so it is lightweight. It allows movement of air, so skin irritation is avoided. It is washable. You can remove the clips on the top, wash your hand, wash the cast, and refit it. Biggest advantage, you can do a 3D scan of the broken part and make a custom-built cast. So it will fit exactly to the broken bone. The second slide on the right shows a silicone bladder, and the net-like thing that you see is a stent. Already, FDA approvals have been obtained for these two items. Putting it inside the human body is under trial, and very soon we will be finding 3D printed stents being put in the patients or bladders being replaced by silicone bladders. Again, the advantage is that they can be custom built. A doctor will insert a very thin laser camera into the blocked artery, take a scan of it, and print it in lab, the stent which will exactly fit into that artery. There is no need to use a ready-made stent, which later on may create problems in the artery. The slide on the corner left-hand eye shows you various small pieces. These are hearing aids, again, custom-built according to the patient's ear. A scan, a 3D scanner is takes a 3D scan and uses that digital file which is generated to print a small component which can easily fit into the ear of the wearer. So it is easy, does not cause any irritation in the ear, and is custom built. On the right hand corner, again, you see a bladder which is designed to replicate a human filtration system. Major application, again, dental field. You see on the first corner slide, a whole denture has been made. Ortho scanners, 3D scanners, are already available. They are as thin as a wire. A patient opens his mouth, the scanner is inserted, a 3D scan is taken. The 3D scanner generates a 3D file, a digital file in STL format, which is sent to a slicer. It is sliced and a whole denture can be printed. The advantage of this is that it is going to be an exact fit, because a 3D scan of the patient's dental system has been taken. The dentist does not have to do a trial and error. Fit one, take it out, grind it, again fit it. That will not happen. Similarly, for bridges, if you see on the second slide at the corner, bridges can be made using a 3D scanner. Biocompatible resins are already available and they are already being used to print these so that there is no harmful reaction in the patient's body. Again, some medical applications. The first slide in the corner that you see is a human skull. This is a picture of a woman in Scandinavia who had a car accident. She crushed her skull. The blue portion that you see was crushed into such small pieces that doctors could not refix it. What they did was they took a 3D scan of that area, printed what is the blue portion you see, and joined it to the skull. The lady is still leading a normal life today and is quite happy that she has got her own skull back. The one in the middle is a heart. Again, a human heart has been developed using bioresins, and the time is not far when human hearts are going to be replaced by silicon or bioresin printed hearts. The slide on the right hand corner you see is a very common thing that is happening all over the world and a common old age problem, knee replacement. Right now, what happens is statistically some sizes have been made of the knees that human beings have, and depending on where you hail from, your weight and your size, a standard knee is used by the doctor. He puts you on the stretcher, makes the incision, takes some measurement, and that standard knee is ground, make some minor modifications and fitted on to the patient's knee. You'll find often that some patients are very comfortable with the replaced knee while some are forever in pain. This is because the customization has not been improper. Now, with a 3D scan, the doctor will take a 3D scan after opening the skin and using a 3D printer, print the replacement right in the operation theater and replace the knee. Therefore, it will be custom built and it will have a fitting as near to a natural knee as possible. Similarly, the slide on the left-hand corner, bottom corner, is an ear fitted with a hearing aid. There is no projection. It looks like a human ear. Only a very small component, which has been custom 3D built, is fitted there. Consumer products is again an area where 3D printers are reducing the money involved and the time in designing. I will share a very small story with you regarding this. Pidlite, you're all aware of, is a company that makes various adhesives, Fevicol, Fevilite, FeviQuick. You must have heard one of those things. They wanted to make a bottle for Fevigum, and they contracted, what I'm talking of is about 7-8 years ago, they contracted a Taiwanese company because Taiwanese companies produce very good quality plastics at a fraction of the cost at which we produce. So they contracted with them to produce the bottle, and they said, we want a 50 ml bottle. The design was made, it was produced, a prototype was made by the Taiwanese company and sent by air to Pidlite. Pidlite filled it with its adhesives and tried to pour it. They found that the capacity was not 50 ml. Because once you fill an adhesive, you have to leave an air gap at the top where you put nitrogen. So there was no space to put nitrogen. So they returned the design and said, this is the problem, please make a fresh prototype. A fresh prototype was made to accommodate that portion where nitrogen could be filled to keep the adhesive fresh. Again, it was sent. The company again refilled it. They got their 50 ml, they were able to fill the nitrogen, but now it was not pouring properly from the nozzle. So again, it was sent back, a third design was produced. So all this took about 6 months to accomplish. Now with a 3D printer, they do it in 1 hour. The CAD designer makes a design, they print it. The next morning, they are ready to use it, pour the liquid. If it works, fine. If it doesn't, make the changes in the CAD drawing. The next day again, they are producing. So imagine the time saved and the cost saved in to and fro of the prototype. I'm showing you these trophy manufacturing prototypes. Trophy manufacturing is a very typical work. First, because trophies are made in very limited number. Nobody makes 1,000 trophies of the same type. And everybody wants a unique trophy. So designers are already on working on different designs. But what if the design cannot be printed? A 3D printer can use that design to produce a prototype. You can see what it looks like, color it, finish it. And if it suits you, you can go for a production, which is a batch production of 50, 100, 500 pieces. Another advantage is you can make print designs which are normally not possible with conventional methods, or using conventional methods becomes very tedious and very costly. If you look at the first trophy on the left, it is a trophy granted by Tata's for as an award for excellence. The beauty of this design is that it is a six-axis design. Besides the three axes that we know of, X, Y, and Z, it is bent in three different directions. Now to make this, it can be made using CNC machines, but the cost of making that program or tool using the tooling will make it prohibitive. Whereas in 3D printer, the cost is minimal. Secondly, it can give you the finish, which is far superior without any post-finishing also. The one in the middle is a World Cup trophy, football World Cup trophy. The last football World Cup trophy was printed using 3D. Later on, it was coated with precious metal. But the basic design was made using 3D printers. Architecture Joshi initially talked about architectural models more in detail than what I'm going to talk here. You can see the first model is a Eiffel Tower model. The left-hand corner on the bottom is a layout. So now you can physically print the layout of a big complex and actually show where the buildings will be, what they will look like, where the green areas will be, where will be the common areas, the road layout, the parking layout, everything you can show to a client using models which are 3D printed. Earlier also it was done by architects, but the cost and time was prohibitive. On the right-hand corner, bottom corner, you can see a very typical design of an architectural building. Now, if this were to be made actually, the contractor who would make would get cold feet because he would not know whether such a span can be allowed to exist and will it not fall. Yes, you can do your structural analysis and prove using civil engineering that no, it will not fall. But still, at the back of the mind, it is always there that will such a design stand up or not. So now you can actually make it in 3D and do a structural analysis even before you put it to a civil engineering construction project. Similarly, you can make furniture, as you see in the right hand corner, which can be of designs that you can think of. It does not have to be mass produced design, because again, you can make a few pieces also. Another application of 3D printing is arts and design. A lot of artists now are combining sculpting and metal forming using 3D printing to give unique designs. You can see the filigree work. This has been printed, and it is not just slides. I will, after finishing the presentation, show you some components which I have printed in my own printers, which are equally delicate. On the right-hand corner, you see a fashion garment, again designed using 3D printer. The advantage of this is you can use different materials, you can make different designs. Some fashion design stores have already installed 3D scanners in their stores, high-end stores, where a customer can walk before the scanner. The scanner will take the actual body dimensions and make you a dress to fit exactly according to the person's physique. So no alterations are required, or you don't have to wear a design actually made in mass quantities and then go to a tailor and say, please tuck in here, make it slightly shorter here or longer here. Those things can be avoided. And secondly, again, you can generate very unique designs. Again, toys can be made, animation figures can be made, jewelry. This is a very big application of 3D printing and already in great use. The pink rings that you see are used using 3D printers, and then using Lostvac investment casting, the actual product is made using precious metals. The advantage of this is you can see the design, get it approved by your client, even you can get the size approved so that later on the jeweler does not have to do anything. Plus, again, as I keep repeating, it can be a very unique design. Each ring can be of a different design and no dies are required, and therefore each client will have something unique. Plus, as you can see in the second slide at the bottom, you can make some very unique designs which making using hand will take a lot of time, and producing by machine will mean a lot of expensive tooling. Again, on the right hand side, you see very intricate designs using 3D printers. These designs can be made, and then you can use either Lostvac or you can even use 3D printers using SLA or SLS. Another important field which Mr. Joshi would be very interested in is application of 3D printers to construction. The first slide on the left you see with a yellow nozzle is a concrete printer with a yellow nozzle. It is printing concrete designs, and the bottom you see is a concrete structure. On the right hand side you see is a three-storied structure which is going to be built using 3D printers, and 3D printers are going to be making the walls, the floor, the ceiling, everything. I will later on show you designs of 3D printed buildings also. China is a leader in this. They have already got concrete printers. Second is US, which is again using concrete printers to make designs, of which I will talk as we go along. Aerospace and defense. Dr. Vilas talked about these things. Already these are in use. The turbo generator that you see on the left, first slide, is a GE turbo generator. That GE, it made in 3D, actually saw whether assembly wise it was okay, did a speed test on it before making it in the desired material. Similarly, the left-hand corner shows a drone. drone technology is really taking off, and most of the drones are 3D printed, because with 3D printing you can make very complex structures, make them very lightweight, and again design drones to suit the equipment that you want to fit into it. On the right, you see some industrial components again. These are again components made using 3D printers. Car designing normally takes millions of dollars, and then again, out of 50 designs that are made, a few are selected for production. So the enormous cost involved in making models, what they will look like, whether assemblies like transmission can be fitted, what should be the interiors look like, all those take a lot of time and a lot of money is involved. With 3D printing, you can eliminate all that. Again, I will show you a 3D printed vehicle as we go along. Another application which is very important is repair and refurbishment. Normally in industrial products like turbines, generators, they are one-off products. A company like BHEL would make one generator or one turbine, which is going to have a life of 30 to 40 years. But meanwhile, some particular part of it may wear out. What do? You cannot replace the generator, and obviously the manufacturer is not going to give you spares because it is 30 years old. At most, they can give you two-dimensional drawings. Using those two-dimensional drawings, either you can make three-dimensional drawings, or you can take a 3D scan of the damaged part, make a 3D model, see where it is worn out, and that particular part which is worn out can be rebuilt using powder technology, powder welding, and other technologies which are possible. So basically, you have replaced that part and the whole product is good as new. A lot of design optimization is being done using 3D printers. One of our guest speakers is on the board of SAE, and he will tell you that SAE runs a program for students where they make model cars and the engine capacity is fixed. But using the same engine capacity, they have to make cars which will go furthest in minimum of fuel. So you have to do an innovation making lightweight components, lightweight designs. So if you see on the left-hand corner bottom, somebody has made a drive shaft using carbon fiber, which reduced the weight of the steel shaft by almost 60%. On the right-hand corner, you will see the design. Again, they have reduced the weight using 3D design. Inhalers, again, custom-built using 3D printers. Turbine blade designed by Siemens, printed in 3D, carried out all the assembly tests, fitment tests, speed test, and then actually produced it in high performance metals to be used commercially. An obsolete part that has been refurbished using 3D printer. Thin wall designs. When we talk of 3D printing, everybody thinks, oh, it is going to be very bulky. It cannot withstand impact. It cannot withstand stresses. These are all things that are have been overcome using thin wall technology. In Amsterdam, a 3D printer is producing some very thin tubes, and they have mastered the idea of shell technology. A lot of components have been produced with very thin walls using advanced material, thus reducing the overall weight, at the same time not compromising on other mechanical features like strength, ability to withstand torsion, and things like that. Design optimization. This again is a very potential field for 3D printing. As you can see, with optimization, the weight has been reduced by 30%. And again, the size looks more appealing. If you look at the left-hand corner, you see a filter which has a number of parts. The red, green, and blue filter that you see, and all the parts that are involved in making this filter. Whereas on the right, you see the purple design. It is a one-part design performing the same functions you printed using a 3D printer. Of course, it has a very unconventional design. The reason is this filter was fitted into a cabinet where the space available was very small. So if we were to use the filter on the left, we would have to make the cabinet bigger. To overcome, the designers took a scan of the space available and made the right-hand filter to fit into that space. It reduced the weight, it reduced the number of moving components. Therefore, there was a lot of cost saving. Similarly, on the top, you see a very complicated structure. It was made using 3D printers. A lot of weight was reduced. Using 3D printers, they first printed the prototype. Once they were satisfied that it will work, the fitments were seen. It was mass produced using conventional technologies. These are some of the applications in education field. The right hand corner, you see a moving gear train was made by a student in one of the Atal labs. Many of you will be aware of what is Atal Tinkering Labs. 3D printers have been supplied to school through government aid, and students as young as class 5 are being encouraged to use the 3D printers to make their designs. So this was a gear train made by a student and printed on a 3D printer. The one above is a car designed by a college student and printed using a pipe structure printed on 3D to reduce the weight. On the left-hand corner is a robotic arm. The electronics is housed in the blue arm, and the fingers are moving. Again, everything is 3D printed. Domains where 3D printing is making a big dent. Aeronautics. You will be surprised to hear that Boeing uses 3D printer to produce 30% of its aircraft. Components, 30% of the components are printed using 3D printers. The reason being cost saving. Secondly, complex designs. Thirdly, limited production required. They may need only one of that component in one aircraft, and they are only going to produce about 600 aircraft of that design. So to produce those 600 pieces, to make the tooling will be very expensive. But with 3D printing, you can make just 600, the cost is minimal, and it serves the purpose. Already somebody has talked about automotive applications. BMW uses 3D printers to produce about 30 to 40% of its components. Their aim is to reach 60% by 2025. Also, the autonomous cars that you hear of, are the shell is being 3D printed because it has to be lightweight, plus it does not require all the mechanical moving components. Dental, I've shown you a lot of applications. Similarly, biomedical. Defense, again, number of components required is very large, but the quantity of each is very small. So in fact, defense is running an indigenization program where it says that please use 3D printers. It is mentioned in their request for quotation that you have to use 3D printers to make those components, because they do realize that using conventional method, the print cost is going to be phenomenal. Electronics also, marine also, same problem. Lifestyle, the same. space research, again, same thing. You require only very small components and at the same time, very high performance material. Titanium powders are used in SLS printers to produce space components, which can withstand very high temperature, friction, impact, and things like that. Just to give you an idea of where 3D printing is headed. If you see from 2011 to 2019, there has been a compound growth of 63%. The number of printers has gone up from 0.47 million to 0.04 million to 1 million. And revenue generated has gone from 0.47 billion to $8.27 billion. So the growth, as you see, is a very steep incline. From 0.4, it increased to 0.5 in 1 year. But from 0.14 to 1.07, that means it has grown 8 times in just 4 years. And in 2020, it is expected that it will have doubled. These are figures. The earlier slide was showing you international growth. This shows you Indian growth. If you look at the first slide, Indian 3D printer market revenue in the year 2011 was only $13,000. But as of 2019, it has gone up to 46,000. That means it has grown by 3.5 times in 9 years. And it is growing at a much faster rate now. Volumes have increased from 480 numbers to 200 in 2011 to 2,400 in 2019. And with Atal Tinkering Lab, it has gone up to over 2 lakh printers already installed in schools. So you can imagine the growth that is taking place. And this is the right time to enter this field. As I mentioned earlier, that I will be showing you a car that is totally 3D printed. This was taken from a local paper where you can see that a low-speed electric vehicle has been completely printed in 3D using 3D printers in Hong Kong. This was a house that has been printed, a 650 square feet house printed in 24 hours, and it is a livable house. Similarly, an 800 square feet house printed using a printer by a company called Vulcan in US, again printed in 48 hours. This is the largest 3D building, 3D printed building, which is now open in Dubai. If you see at the back, you will see two storage containers, which are also called silos, with a conical bottom. Those silos were used for storing the concrete resin. The printer was installed at site, and this building of 640 square meters, which is 6,400 square meters, the almost the size of 6 flats of 3 BHK. It was printed using a 3D printer, and Dubai has set itself a target of printing 25% of all the buildings using 3D printers by the year 2025. That means within the next 5 years. So that was my presentation. Thank you very much for listening to that. You have my contact details there. The landline number has changed to 490. Okay, it has changed to 490. So that is the correct number that has been printed. Plus, you have my mobile number. If you have any queries, you're most welcome to contact me. I will now show you a video of 3D printing also. Give me a minute to start that video. How do we get video share?
Thank you. Nice presentation, sir.
I will be showing you a video also, Professor Jain. Please give me a minute.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Please, sir. Please proceed. Yeah. Please proceed.
This is a Delta printer, which you can see. फाइल करना चाहिए Are you able to see the printer?
Yes, sir. It's okay. Visible.
This is a Delta printer as opposed to the Cartesian printer that earlier Mr. Joshi was showing. In this, you see the head is floating, the base is fixed, and it is the head which will rise along the X direction. The SD card has been fed below the display board. And it has been given instructions to print along the X, Y, and Z axis. The coordinates have been given, and the printer
3D printing conference or workshop.
The printer is dropping the filament. The white filament you can see has gone into the header. It is being melted by a heater, and drop by drop, the material is being deposited onto the bed. This is the base being formed, and as it receives instruction from the SD card, it will keep rising. You see, it has gone up a few layers. Again, more of the product has been printed. You see, it is rising along the Z axis. Is the focus clear? Can everybody see that? Is the focus clear? Can everybody see the product being made?
Yes.
Jainthap, can you see the product being made?
Very clear.
Visible. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Clearly visible. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Okay. On the display board, you will see that it is showing you something like 191/190. That is the temperature which the heater has generated, through which the PLA material is melting and depositing through the header. The X coordinate, Y coordinate, and Z coordinate are being shown. So along the X, now it is depositing the material at 13, along Y at Y, and along Z at 5 millimeters. Also, you see something which is being shown as a percentage, SD051%. So that shows how much printing has taken place. So already 53% of the product has been printed. Then you see on the right hand corner 00:08. So it shows that the printer has been on for 8 minutes, and in 8 minutes it has printed 56%. The product that is being made, I'll just show you the product. I already have the product with me. I'm showing it to you before the camera. Please let me know if you can see the product. Can you see the product, the finished product?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It is in the shape of an L. So this was the product that we are producing here. Okay. So we have very advanced printers now, which tell you how much printing is going on. You can fix what is the way. It also shows you before this in the slicing software, the amount of material you will require, what will be the weight of the object, how much time it will take. You can also vary those things in the software. For example, you can make a hollow product also. If you see this, this is a heart that we printed. Can you see the red figure in my hand? It is a heart. It is an hollow heart. So to reduce the time that is required to print it, we made it hollow. It has a very small wall thickness. So we adjusted the time. Otherwise, to print the actual heart would have taken much longer. On the other hand, we have also made a solid product. You can see here. Can you see the skull? Can you see the skull, everyone? Is the skull visible to you? Then we have some more components, very complex components. If you see this, this is an octagonal body. It has holes on all sides, drilled cleanly. But this has been made using a 3D printer with no tooling required. It was only a CAD design printed using a 3D printer here, which you have also see on the screen. It took us about 3.5 hours to print it, but no further tooling was required. And it even gives you, if you look closely, slight indentation as required in the drawing. Can you see the fine work? Then some more mechanical components that we printed. This is a bolt and a nut. More importantly, this bolt is a dual start thread. For those who are with a mechanical background will understand. A dual start thread. You can see at the bottom, you can see the dual start and a nut, both printed on the same printer, and you can actually fit it. You can see the nut going over the bolt. Then we have printed some complex pieces also. You can see this bearing. It is a movable bearing printed in one shot. We did not print the outer and inner race separately and the ball separately. Everything was printed in one shot only on a single printer. Sir, do we have time to show more specimens, or would you like me to wind up? Jain sir?
Sir, please proceed.
No, do you have time, or do you want me to show some more samples?
Yes, sir, please.
Okay. I showed you some art and craft. So this is a design that we printed. You can see very thin lines. Can you see that? Is it visible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. Then these are all things we made using PLA. This is a Ganesh ji. You can see the fine artwork. Can you see that? And we made this using a material called fluorescent material. So it is visible even in the absence of light. This we made for an artist. It shows a lighthouse with an old type sailing boat with sails. Can you see that? And it gives the effect of depth as well as shading. Some areas are dark, some are light. Can everyone see that? The shading, the complex design. So that is the end of my presentation and some samples that I've shown you, which I've printed. If you have any questions, you are most welcome to ask, and I'll try my best to reply to your questions.
Nice presentation, very informative one. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Jain. I hope that you have a printer at your institute. If you don't, you should start the process of getting one.
Sure, sure.
Even after this presentation, if you have any queries, you are free to contact me. You already have my numbers, or you can contact me through RFI.
I noted it.
Yeah.
Yeah. So thank you so much, Deepak sir. We are all aware that no one can explain this better than you. You have explained in detail about this technique. You told about the current and future work of this technology. Your experience is unique in this area, and this same experience and knowledge of yours is useful for us to understand this technology. You explained, sir. Digital fabrication technology, also referred to as 3D printing or additive manufacturing, creates a physical object from a geometrical presentation by successive addition of materials. 3D printing technology is a fast emerging technology. Nowadays, 3D printing technology is widely used in the world. 3D printing technology increasingly used for the mass customization production of any types of open source design in the field of agriculture, in healthcare, automotive industry, locomotive industry, and aviation industry. 3D printing technology can print an object layer by layer, deposition of material directly from a computer aided design CAD model. This session present the overview of the steps of 3D printing technologies, the application of 3D printing technology, and lastly, the material used for 3D printing technology in manufacturing industries. So thank you very much, sir, for letting us know about this important technology. Hope to learn a lot from you in future too. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you, Deepak, sir. Thank you so much.
There is a query from one of the participants. Somebody has asked, how do you manage the thickness of the product, the layer thickness? In the slicing software, you can set the layer thickness. It is available. You can modify it as you want. If you keep the layer thickness very small, then the time taken becomes very long. At the same time, if you keep the layer thickness very high, then the finish on the product is not very nice. It is rough. But normally, you can adjust the thickness of the layer from 5 microns to 100 microns. Have I answered your question, whoever asked this question? Has your question been answered?
Hello, sir. Actually, I have asked the question.
Okay. Has it been answered?
Yes, sir. I have an FDM printer and I know how it control. I am asking about some powder-based technology.
In powder-based, do you have SLS printer?
No, sir. I have FDM and I know how the layer thickness, that is 0.8 times of your nozzle dye that we are taking actually.
Yes.
Okay. So how we control in SLS, how the powder has been taken and what the grain size of the powder that affects the layer thickness and how much amount, minimum or maximum thickness that we can take?
That will depend on the material you are using. For example, if you are using a titanium compound, the titanium grain size will be fixed by the manufacturer. You cannot go below the grain size. At the same time, nobody produces at grain size. You will always go X times the grain size, because otherwise fusion will make very thin layers and the product is likely to crack.
Okay, thank you, sir.
What is the difference between 3D printing? I was not able to read that question. Can you repeat it, please? Somebody had asked about difference between 3D printing and... would the participant ask the question again, please? There was a question regarding 3D printing and... some participant wanted a question. I was not able to read the question. Sir, can you turn on the chat feature? I can then read the question.
Sir, we can collect question from chat box and send to you.
Yes, that you can do.
And also using WhatsApp group.
Okay, I am able to read the question. The question is, what is the difference between 3D printing and sculpting techniques, and they are in reverse methods? Well, sculpting techniques can be either layer by layer, or it can be starting from a solid block and sculpting it down. When you use a solid block and sculpt it down, like for example, what the stonemasons do, it is a subtractive manufacturing. You are removing material. But if you are going to add material or shape the material as the potters do on a potter wheel, that can be called as additive manufacturing. Whereas 3D printing is additive manufacturing only. We only add material. We never remove any material. Are they reverse methods? Well, you can use a 3D model as a model for your sculpting needs, but you cannot use a sculpting model for 3D printing, because anyway, you'll have to again use a 3D scanner to scan it and generate a digital file. Have I answered your question, sir? Mr. Sanjeet Kumar? Are you satisfied with the answer, or do you have more queries? Oh, he has left the meeting. Okay. Any more questions? Thank you, Mr. Prabhu. If you have any questions, I'll welcome them. If there are no more questions, then I will hand over the session back to Jain Sam. Thank you very much, yes, everyone, sir, for participating in this program.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you, Deepak, sir. और आपके साथ बहुत सारी एक्टिविटी हमने ऑलरेडी की है, और आगे भी इस टेक्नोलॉजी का हमको समझना और आगे बढ़ना है. सो अगेन थैंक यू सो मच सर. थैंक यू सो मच सर. सर आज हमारे साथ में वरिष्ठ प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर एम एल जैन सर भी है, जो AICTE मार्गदर्शक स्कीम में है, और उनका मार्गदर्शन भी हमारे लिए जरूरी है. सो आई इनवाइट डॉक्टर एम एल जैन सर. सर प्लीज एड्रेस अस एंड गाइडेंस अस. थैंक यू सो मच सर.
या आई अंडरस्टैंड एवरीवन कैन लिसन मी एंड सी मी. I am audible to all of you.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So, first of all, thank you very much to the Research Foundation for providing these platforms and choosing the emerging areas in today's scenario. As the creative technology is very well explained regarding the scenario of 3D printing, its principle of working and its applications, and Mr. Joshi initially has elaborated in a very informative way the functionalities and working of a 3D printers. I am happy with their presentation and their elaborate study in these connections. I am just giving a brief overviews regarding this 3D printing scenario today. Looking to the very basic principle that 3D printer. Hello.
Yes, sir. You are audible. Please
tell me. Yeah.
Okay. So basically, it is working on a additive manufacturing process, like additive of one layer over another layer. It is different in the sense of earlier conventional manufacturing process. As we know, there are in previous time we are using only conventional, that is subtractive manufacturing process, where in case if we interested to develop a product, then we have to use the raw material in a lump forms, and we subtract the materials which is not needed in our product, desired product. So we are removing the material in the form of chips, and we are giving the desired shape to the product. And for those things, the conventional manufacturing process like lathe machine, shape machine, milling machine was used. In this particular case, it is not subtractive, but it is an additive process. So here there is no loss of material, but in case of subtractive process, there is a lot of wastage of materials are there in the form of chips. But here we are adding the materials. 3D printer is basically a robotic device which work on the input that whatever we have supplied it, that you produce that kind of models in a physical format. So the two major parameters involved into this one is one, how to model the desired object, desired product on a virtual platform. So that is also a big challenge for the product to be developed. So one who is very experts in modeling kind of things, and he is having all details regarding the features which are to be developed, which are to be desired. So he can work on a software, and he will develop a product on a 3D platforms in a very different kinds of software which are available in a CAD domains, like CATIA, UniGraphics, like Creative Technology presently gave so many applications regarding Siemens. Siemens is the major software vendors regarding the UniGraphics, which is one of the top class of 3D modeling kinds of solid modeling kind of software. So whatever may be the platform that we are using for the software for 3D modeling, first principle which is involved for the product to be developed in a 3D printer is to virtually model the product in a 3D solid modeling platform. And once you are satisfied with its finite element analysis, I mean to say that the virtual testing, if you have satisfied, then you have to go for the real experimental testing also on the product. And until and unless the real experimental testing, we don't have product with our hand, we can't proceed for the experimental testing. So for that kind of things, the latest technologies that we have is 3D printing. So whatever the product that we develop on a virtual platform on a display units, the same platform, the same models, which is to be exported in a STL format, that is stereolithography format. All 3D printer, as far as I understand, they are welcoming the file format of STL. They are not taking the JPG format. They are not taking a DOC format like that. They are welcoming only STL file format. So once you model the product in a solid modeling platform, you export it in a STL format, and then you import that STL format in a 3D printer, and then the machine has got its own software, its own machine language software, where it slices the product into different layers, and it also give the road width, and it also give the layer thickness, which are very important for the surface finish of the product that you are going to build into the 3D printer. So overall, the surface finish of the 3D physical component is basically many parameters are there. One is how to orient the model into the platform of a 3D printer. Then what are the road width you have taken into the platform? And then what is the layer thickness you have taken? Apart from this, there are also many parameters in software, in machine's language of 3D printer itself. Basically, there are three kinds of 3D printers are available. One is solid-based 3D printers. Then you are having liquid-based 3D printers. And one, you are having the powder-based 3D printer. As Creative Technologies and Mr. Joshi elaborated over here, mostly they have elaborated regarding the software.
Dr. Jay. Sir, please unmute your mic.
Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Actually, just now the light has gone, so I am working on mobile right now. So basically, three kinds of devices are there: liquid based, solid based, and powder based. Liquid based basically uses the resin in a chemical format, and the material is cured with the help of photopolymerization processes or laser curing methods. And powder based material, which are mostly used in a metal manufacturing 3D printer kind of things. Mostly the powder manufacturing processes, raw material are used in a powder form. And there we are using different materials of different powders, and we can have the product into that metallic format. On the other hand, in a solid based format, we are using filament kinds of things, and it melted and then it is deposited in a layer away process. So these are different classifications of rapid prototyping systems. And I have some models over here that I'll show you again over here. I think you can see if I'm rotating over here my mobiles, and you can see here. Can you see these models?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this is actually the hip joints. This is actually the hip joint that we see in age group, later age group, senior people's, mostly the acetabulum of hip kinds of things. It's broken, break over here at these crucial points, which is replaced with a metallic parts into the after the surgery, right? And you can see the rake chain pinion kind of thing, which is developed by my student here itself in a lab. Then you are having this. I think you can see over here. This is another rake and pinion kind of arrangement, and it is Then I have also developed with my students a human foot with X-ray exposures, X-ray database in mimics, materialized mimics platforms.
and also develop anatomical models of this various joints of the foot. And you can see over here that we can study the various joints, various bone, ligament, tendon kind of things, that how they are flexible, how they are working. And if someone having this deformities, we can also study that one. I have in my laboratories one printer, that is 3D printer, that most of the time I am working on this 3D printer. You can see this is a small 3D printer which can build a product of around 9 inch by 9 inch by 9 inch size. You can see over here. Currently it is off positions, but you can see the materials and other details. One having the display units, means you can see here the total material. Sorry, can, oh, I just use a front. Can you see all those details?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Is it visible to you, this machine?
Yes, sir. It's visible.
I thought big camera is into action. So this is just a platform. I produced this one also from this printer. You can see this one I produced with this 3D printer itself, right? So like that, I am doing the experiment with my students, and some of the product we are developing into the laboratories, and some activities we are doing. We are running a specialization postgraduate course in the department also, that is CAD, CAM, and CAE. So students are doing their lot of projects, activities on this 3D printer modeling, simulations kind of thing, and they are developing the experimental product also in different areas. So with that, I'm thank you, Research Foundations of India, and Dr. Professor Gupta ji and Jain sir for providing me the platform. I understand today's gathering is very informative, and lot of demonstrations and informations in these emerging areas are distributed with this platform. Thank you very much.
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद सर. प्रैक्टिकल एस्पेक्ट से इससे देखने को हम लोगों को मिले हैं, आपके प्रयास, आपके स्टूडेंट के एफर्ट्स, आपके द्वारा किए गए काम, और प्रैक्टिकल एस्पेक्ट बेसिकली जो देखने के लिए मिले. वास्तव में ये वर्कशॉप, अब वेबिनार पूरी तरह सक्सेस है. दीपक वोरा सर ने सारी चीज़ों के बारे में, सारी टेक्नोलॉजी के बारे में, इस चीज़ के विषय में डिटेल में इंफॉर्मेशन दी, और उसी चीज़ का प्रैक्टिकल एस्पेक्ट आपने भी बताया सर. सो थैंक यू सो मच. हमेशा आपका गाइडेंस और सपोर्ट मिलता रहे. आरएफआई की तरफ से बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद. थैंक यू सर. थैंक यू सो मच सर. सो मे आई इन्वाइट नाउ डॉक्टर अशोक कुमार गुप्ता सर. सर प्लीज एड्रेस आर एंड गाइड अस. डॉक्टर अशोक गुप्ता सर.
हेलो एवरीवन. हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर अशोक कुमार गुप्ता. I feel honored to be invited in this online international webinar on 3D printing technology and additive manufacturing. Focus areas discussed by various learned speakers were overview of additive manufacturing, process of additive manufacturing, additive manufacturing using metals, role of additive manufacturing in new product development and design, optimization, rapid tooling concepts, rapid manufacturing possibilities and future needs. Live demo of equipments for making parts were also displayed. It has been long believed that the most important resource that any institution of higher education has its faculty members who teach knowledge and skills to students. Such sessions have proven to be successful for improving teaching skills in higher education. These produce promising outcomes in the learning and teaching practices. I have been attending the various sessions from RFI from the beginning and learned a lot. As we know, learning is a never-ending process. The beautiful thing about learning is that nobody can take
it away from us. Change is the end result of all learning. Every moment is a fresh beginning. This program was organized by Research Foundation of India and World Virtual Conference Forum, and the sponsored by World Federation of Science and Technology Information Research Guide Federation, JHERF, and Edu Academy. If you have any query, please mail us at info@researchfoundationofindia.com. For further such seminars and other information, you can visit our URL www.researchfoundationofindia.com. I'd like to thank Dr. P.K. Chande sir, Dr. Vilas Varudkar sir, Ms. Daksha from USA, Engineer Deepak Bora, Architecture, Aishwarya Joshi sir, Professor Dr. M.L. Jain sir, Dr. Sandeep Salotkar sir, Dr. Priyadarshini Agnihotri ma'am, Dr. Saurabh Jain, Professor Ajay Jain, and all the participants. I'm thankful to all who has given his or her input in this webinar, and all participants who made this session a success. The participants are not those who are sitting here and attending the seminar, but the content of this webinar has been shared through electronic media and would be available for everyone. Thanks again. Over to you, Professor Ajay Jain, for delivering a formal vote of thanks. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for your valuable suggestions, guidance. Always be there. Thank you so much, sir. Hamesha hamare liye uplabdh rehne ke liye, hame margdarshan karne ke liye. Honorable Chairman, Vice President, Honorable Chief Guest and Guest Speakers, dearest team members, all faculty members, hello, all faculty members and our most valued participants, a pleasant afternoon to this wonderful gathering. I, Professor Ajay Jain, President, Central Board of India, Research Foundation of India, feels privileged to stand before this gathering to process, propose a vote of thanks. As we express our gratitude, we must never forget that the highest appreciation is not to utter words, but to live by them. First and foremost, we thank the Lord Almighty who has designed and refreshed our souls with a sweet stream of blessings. Thank you, Lord. I express my gratitude to our Honorable Chairman, Dr. Saurabh Jain, respected Vice President, Dr. Ashok Kumar Gupta, sir, to organize such a wonderful event on this virtual platform. We have been fortunate enough to have some of the eminent person from academia, industry, and utility working in different areas was present here to grace the occasion. I am sure that the participants must have benefited by attending this webinar. My heartfelt thanks to our Honorable Chief Guest and Guest Speaker, and also Subject Expert Dr. Deepak Bora sir of the day, who really generously accepted our invitation, spared their precious time for busy schedule and shared their valuable knowledge and expertise with us. Thank you, dear sir and madam. We are very much thankful to all the sponsors on this conference. Without their generous support, it would not have been possible to organize this webinar. I am sure your support will continue in the future also. I express my gratitude to our team members of RFI, our technical team, for their hard work and tireless efforts. It has been our pleasure to host all the participants of this international webinar. At this juncture, I feel privileged to thank you all the participants for attending virtual webinar. I once thank everyone who's contributed this, made this webinar a successful webinar. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, all of you. Thank you all guests. Thank you, Dr. Deepak Bora sir. Thank you all special guest, Dr. Jain sir, Chande sir, Varun sir, or Aishwarya Joshi sir. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, all of you.
Thank you.
Dr. Saurabh Jain, sir.
Thank you, Professor Jain. At last, I would like to congratulate to all person from RFI, dignitaries, chief guest, special guest, Vice President RFI, and a special thanks to all the participants. Definitely, in coming scenario, we will come with some new innovative thing, whatever can be utilized for our future. So thank you very much. Thank you. Over to you, Professor Jain, please.
Thank you so much, sir. So again, thank you. Thank you so much, all participants, all guests, and today, especially thanks to today's expert, Dr. Deepak Bora, sir. Vikas, sir. So now, all participants leave me. Session is end. Thank you so much, all of you. Thank you. So
thank
much.
You. Thank you.
Thank you, Jain, sir. Thank you. Thank you, Gupta ji. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Gupta. Thank you, Jain.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.